After long waiting for Dorney Park enthusiasts, the park is finally receiving a new and unique coaster. Stinger opened in 2012 and closed in 2017, and that was the last coaster the park got. After countless teasers, including an abandoned factory, Dorney Park finally revealed their brand new B&M Dive Coaster this morning. Here's my complete breakdown of Iron Menace coming to Dorney Park in 2024. Let's start off with the basic stats of the ride. Iron Menace is one of the biggest rides in Dorney Park. It stands 160 feet tall, exactly as initially predicted with the plans, and reaches speeds of 64 miles per hour. It features four inversions, which was unexpected for some who predicted it having three. It is a shorter coaster, having a ride duration of 90 seconds over 2,169 feet of track. It's definitely on the smaller side, but for Dorney Park, a smaller park, it is perfect. And capacity shouldn't be an issue. With two trains, 21 people per train, and a short ride duration, capacity should be perfect for Dorney Park. Now that we have the stats done, let's talk about the actual coaster. A lot of people's most anticipated thing about Iron Menace was the theme and the name. I expected an abandoned factory theme. I really have no opinion on the name, but I did anticipate a more haunted theme compared to the traditional factory theme with what we got. The way it was filmed made it seem more spooky than it actually is. Here's the theme of the ride as read from Dorney Park's website. In the early 1900s, Scottish businessman McTavish opened McTavish Steel Mill, a direct competitor to Bethlehem Steel Company. Greed dictated McTavish's every move, and he was well known to prioritize profits above people. With an eye on maximizing output, McTavish created a massive hauler he dubbed Iron Menace, a device the steel industry had never seen. The rail transporter moved workers and ore at record volumes and dizzying speeds. So the factory theme in the teasers was accurate, but the mood the ride set was not. But the brand new haunted house for this season will actually tie in with the theme. So while the ride isn't as spooky as it was teased, the haunted house might be. However, that doesn't change the fact that this ride will be the best themed ride in the park. The ride is located in the worst part of the park in my opinion, the empty area over by Possessed, where the only ride was Cedar Creek Flyers. From the animation, it looks like that flat ride remains untouched. I predicted that Cedar Creek Flyers could be rethemed, but the queue area and station itself looks very cool for Iron Menace, and the nearby train ride called Zephyr even goes through part of the factory. So while the area doesn't look as well updated as other Cedar Fair areas, it looks great for a park with little theming. And I do see more theming elements not in the announcement, such as shipping containers being placed around the infield of the ride to enhance the experience. Now let's talk about the layout of the ride. A lot of people already knew the layout, but we'll still go over it now that it's official. After dispatching from the station, riders immediately climb up the 160-foot tall lift hill. Yes, that means no pre-show as I predicted could happen. However, it wasn't really necessary for this coaster. I'm happy with the theming. After reaching the top, riders hang over the 95-degree drop. Just like Cliffhanger, this drop is beyond vertical. I heard only great things about that ride, so I'm excited to experience this first drop. After diving down the beyond vertical drop, riders immediately enter a tight element, which transitions the train around the back of the drop. This will make for a good hang time element and also some great head choppers with the drop. Riders then twist up into a weightless 0G roll element. This will then lead into an inclined loop, the only one on a dive coaster. This looks like an extremely tight inversion, which will provide some great positives to mix up the more floaty style inversions. The ending of this layout is where the predictions weren't 100% accurate. Some predictions had it right, while others believed the ride to enter an airtime hill before popping into the brakes. The actual layout continues with an extended corkscrew, which looks to provide more hang time instead of whippy moments. That's perfectly fine, as the 0G roll looks to be whippier. Finally, the ride traverses a tight helix before rising into the brake run. There is no airtime pop into the brake run. While I wish there was, this layout is still perfectly fine for Dorney Park. So let's get into my overall thoughts. I think that this is a perfect fit for Dorney Park, and it's going to look great as well. The orange color is going to pop on the skyline on the drive into the park and from the highway. Am I a little disappointed in the theme or layout? Not really. They could have done more with the theme, but they really didn't need to. Also, there still could be more theming later on that isn't shown in the actual announcement. For example, the Haunt attraction, which is also going to share the same theme. And having it themed to the local industry is pretty genius, with residents being able to actually connect with this addition. And it's good that Dorney is getting a coaster with a vertical drop. While inversions weren't really necessary in the park's lineup, this ride still has a good mix of forces that is great for the park. It has positive inversions, floaty inversions, and hang time filled inversions. So is Iron Menace a good fit for Dorney? Absolutely. It's super different from anything at Great Adventure in Hershey, and I'm hoping that this is a sign that Dorney will be building more coasters in the future. Finally, Cedar Fair has invested in Worlds of Fun this year and Dorney next year. This could mean that Valley Fair or Michigan's Adventure could be up next for a new coaster. Iron Menace is exciting for the future of Dorney and the chain as a whole. I'm super excited to experience Iron Menace, and it could very well be the best coaster in the park, and maybe the best dive coaster in the States. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. Comment what you think of Iron Menace, and have a great rest of your day.